Magandang araw, class. Welcome to our subject, Civil Engineering Laws, Ethics, Contracts, and Specification. This is Sir Bogart. Today, we will be discussing the construction industry. At the same time, an introduction of the construction law. So, allow me to share my screen. In 3, 2, 1... So first, take a look at this take a look at this list 1 to 10 top 10 richest Filipinos in our country. What can you notice on this list? Anong napapansin niyo dito? So paki-pause niyo muna. No? Paki-pause niyo muna 'to. I gave you 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Now, yan. Highlighted class are the people who are in line with the construction industry. Basically, in engineering. No? In engineering and construction. So we have the C siblings. They have the SM Prime Holdings and the SMDC, Development Corporation. Manuel Villar, mga Vista, mga Camellia Homes. Gokong Way, Robinsons. We have Ayala. Alam niyo yan, no? Mga malls, mga sa housing din. Tony Tan Kak Chong, the founder or the CEO of Jollibee Food Corporation. So, kahit saan, no? Kahit saan lugar sa Pilipinas, merong Jollibee. Ramon Ang, sa CEO of San Miguel Corporation. And we have Andrew Tan for Mega World Corporations. So almost, no, 70%, again, Pareto principle class, 70% of the richest people have something to say when it comes to construction. Diba, it gives us an idea that may pera sa construction. Diba? And when there is money, class, no, when there are information about money, papasok syempre yung ethical standards. Kaya normal lang na pag-usapan natin siya in this subject. Okay? So let's now talk about the construction. Oh, ito pa pala, no? This was way back in 2019 when I created the first version of the module of this topic na we are expecting at 130 trillion industry. Take note, just trillion pesos in the new 2013 roadmap. Okay? That is the 20, bakit 2030 pala, no? Bakit 2030 is the Philippine development plan, no? PDP yung tawag na. So and that former trade secretary Ramon Lopez. So ito yung projection when it comes to growth ng construction business, construction industry. So let's talk about the construction industry and the construction law. Basically, what is construction? We have talked about this in your construction materials, maybe in your construction management, in your major years, no, in your fourth year. But now, let's just define again, no, formally, that construction covers a range of activities so vast it makes composing a single, all-comprehensive definition of construction a bit of a challenge. The construction process itself represents a network of transactions that can be as complex as the project can be undertaken. From scoping, meaning you're taking a bird's eye view of what can what's probable to happen. Ano yung pwede mong magawa, ano yung pwede mong ma-construct sa isang bakanting lote na to, di ba? From an idea, you know, from a problem, you are offering a technical solution, merong bakanting palayan sa BGC, no? Tatayuan yun ngayon ng isang treatment plant para malinis, no, from upgrade from 20 million liters per day, you will be times 5. You will be giving 100 million liters per day discharge to the Laguna Lake. Hindi na siya ganun kadumi at the same time. Of a construction idea to designing it and actual executing it and then erecting the physical structure to maintaining these structures. So that's how we define a construction process na construction project, building of infrastructure. Okay? So, bakit nga ba siya importante sa ating economic growth? It's basically part of the national account. So, it creates capital formation, di ba? There are thousands of construction business all over the country. It builds capital formation at the same time, promotes nga economy, the industry. What do you mean by this, Cass? This is actually an interesting data, no? According to my research, that it provides work, di ba? Maraming laborers, ang daming foreman, ang daming mga graduate ng TESDA, mga welders, mga expert when it comes sa electrical wiring, di ba? Lahat yun, they are a form part of this industry that takes part to the growth of GDP natin, di ba? Sa development ng ating ekonomiya. Construction refers to the value of economic activities by establishments engaged in the creation of residential and non-residential structures. No need to identify. Alam na natin yun. O yung residential, ito yung mga domestic na titiran, non-residential, commercial, industry, no? Development. Additions and alterations to existing structures and other land improvements. Technical services, manufacture of construction materials by horizontally integration, construction firms, and informal construction activities such as on-account construction. So, people such as us, no? Ako rin, I started my own construction, though sadly, unfortunately, nag-fail siya way back 2019. Pero I'm not closing my doors, no? I know someday na babalik din naman ako sa construction. I'm just trusting the process. So, yan. Tayo mismo, we can have our own account in construction firms. Diba? Kaya nga sabi natin, it takes sobrang daming contribution when it comes to the industry. Okay? So take a look at this data again. So this was way back 2010. Sorry, hindi ko na na-update yung chart na to. But tingnan nyo naman. Yung outgrowth, how the construction industry outgrown the gross domestic product. Ano ba yung GDP, class, by the way? So ito yung summarize basically the economy of the Philippines. We can summarize in this chart. Okay? And how it is almost double, no? Almost double yung nabibigay ng construction industry sa atin. Some subsectors for the construction, residential and non-residential. Don't need to elaborate. Ayan, interestingly, that construction being a labor-intensive industry, it only takes part of 1 to 2%. Ang data kasi guys is 4,000 out of 4 million workers, no? This year. In the recent first quarter statistics of Department of Finance. Ang onti lang, no? Bakit? Kasi marami rin na wala naman sa construction. Probably nasa private practice of ako, di ba? Nasa teaching, di ba? Meron na sa BPO. Meron na sa restaurants, mga commercial activities, di ba? Pwede mo. So this is an interesting data na kahit na alam natin na labor intensive siya, konti lang yung talagang naging take part sa national employment. Kaya minsan, di ba, lumalabas ng bansa. Kasi mas bigger yung opportunities outside the country. Okay? Employment is concentrated in occupation groups where competition and substitutability among workers is strong and turnover rates are high, especially for workers with little or no training in or field of specialization. So some technicalities can be learned from TESDA and ito, Construction Manpower Development Foundation. Okay? So, paano nga ba maging contractor? Ito na, no? Hindi kasi pwede, class, na kukuha ka lang basta-basta ng mga project. Actually, hindi legal yun. No? Hindi legal sa batas. Hindi pa pwede yun. And we're talking about laws. So let's talk about the technicalities. So according to the RA 4566, the construction, the contractors law, no? as amended by PD 1746, provides that no contractor shall engage in the business of contracting without first having secured a PCAB license. So the first and foremost rule, the general rule, no, is hindi ka pwedeng mag-practice ng contracting, ng construction, hindi ka pwedeng maging contractor if wala kang lisensya in conducting such business. Pwedeng contractor ka ng, nalala ko yung boss ko dati, no, class, contractor lang siya ng mga drainage. Yung ano lang, mga tagas ng tubig, no? So, contractor siya noon, itatakpan, makayos na yung mga drainage, yun, ganyan. Pwede yun. Drainage, electrical, no? Yan ang umuntata ka na ng residential houses. Papaangat, okay? Papaangat. So, you know, the law is hard, but it is the law. It is an offense to engage in contracting business without a license first being obtained. Including also plans and specifications for what to be contracted in the Philippines shall stipulate in the invitation to bidders whether a resident of the Philippines or not in the specifications that will be necessary for any bidder where contractor, subcontractor, or specialty contractor to have license before his bid is considered. So the purpose of the law, the title of the law pala by the way class is the Contractor's License Law, is to ensure for the, again, safety, the number one of priority natin, the upholding safety of the public, that only qualified and reliable contractors are allowed to undertake construction in the country. So yan. So the law provides, aims to promote social justice in any endeavor of the public and private sectors. So, maiksi lang pala, no? Maiksi lang pala itong lecture na ito. Bakit? Because I want you to read class on the following laws. Bibigyan ko kayo ng mga readings. So, andito. Ay, mali. Eto to class. Take a look at this. I'll give you some of the readings, no? Yan. Ano lang to? These are just 7 rules. 7 laws, no? Kahit yung ano lang, background. So, tingnan natin, no? Ay, wala pa lang laman. Kailangan na itong download. Sige, bigyan ko na lang kayo ng PDF. Yan, example ito. Pa-downloadable, no? Ito na. Kahit read, ano lang, read lang the summary of the guidelines of the law. Ano ibig sabihin nito? Merong interagency committee. How to apply for IRC. So some general rules. Anong take part dito? Anong mga parte ng classification of contractors? Though, kahit hindi nyo na pala basahin to, no? Pero mahalaga kasi na may idea tayo. The PCAB board. Hindi ko na papabasa. Ang pangit yung pagkakaskan. Ito na lang gawin natin. So, dito sa Drive Kasi class, I uploaded a PCAB form. So, you can read on this. No? Yeah. If you take a look at this, dito yung categorization classification. Ito na. So, yun yung nakalagay kanina, no? Yun yung mga pwede mong practice when you are an established contractor in the Philippines. So whether class A, you can take part on general engineering, pwede ka makipag-bid sa mga public projects, no? For public bidding. And category, ano yung minimum net worth? Naalala nyo class, yung minimum net worth, we are considering the shares, the total capacity ng isang corporation, no? In this case, 1 billion pesos. Which is 60% of the investment is owned by Filipino people. So yan, AAA, 180 million minimum. Ano yung mga quadruple A, mga DMCI, yan, quadruple A yan. Minimum mga billionaires. No? General Building, Classification B. So no need to memorize, by the way, class. Has to have an understanding na hindi pa pwedeng lahat. Eh, hahalukan mo, di ba? Hindi ka pwedeng mag-take part sa isang irrigation project, sa isang flood control project ni MMDA or ni DPWH if ano ka, practicing ka ng general classification B. Yun lang inasaan mo. Kasi tingnan natin yung form, by the way. Ito yung form. So, kailangan mo magpasa nito and upon approval din. Nakita nyo dito, anong type ng firm nyo? Corporation ba kayo? Sole proprietorship? Ano yung title ng business mo? And so on. Dito, ito na. Oh. Tingnan nyo, class. Anong category kayo? Diba? Kung category D ka lang, hindi ka pwedeng mag-take part sa category A. Diba? Parang ganun. Ito ka lang. Oh. Category dito ka lang. For small projects, small scale projects. So, correct me. Ito pala, mani-mani-mani dito. Ang classification pala yung tinutukoy natin dito. Pag small project ka lang, hindi ka pwedeng mag-take part sa bigger projects. Yun ang ibig namin sabihin. Okay? If you have a specialty for foundation works, example, sila Sir Aj, no? They have this firm na their specialization is foundation works, no? Geotechnical works. So depending on their net worth, pwede silang mag-take part on bigger projects if they are AA, AAA, and higher. So usually kasi, maganda pala na no, yung sa mga public bidding, mayroon tayong we can invite someone who can share. So medyo mahaba siya, no? And dapat rin nire-review talaga ito upon submission. So, I'll giving this all of these files for you to read on. And sige, isama ko na rin ito sa mga sinisipan. Sa mga laws governing the construction industry. Okay? So, yun lang. Short but sweet. If you have any question, class, you can email me, comment down in this video. And mag-ingat kayo palagi. God bless you.